Hi viewers, I'm Dr. Mohan Prasad, Chairman of VGM Gastro Center at Coimbatore. Today I'll just share some interesting facts on gastroesophageal reflux disease. In other words, in the layman's term, it's heartburn. Many of us experience heartburn, so when we eat spicy food. So did you know that the heartburn could happen because of the stomach contents coming into the food pipe whenever we eat spicy food or oily food, or even at other times? Did you know that the reflux disease itself could be genetic? People in Minnesota County, the United States, a decade back demonstrated that the genes that code for the reflux disease could be transmitted through 5 generations. So sometimes even skipping generations. So if dad, a mom, or granddad, a grandmom had reflux disease, there are chances that you and I can get the reflux disease. So how do we prevent this reflux disease? One is we have to keep our weight optimal. And if we are obese, we should shed some weight to get into a BMI of about 24. Also, we should mind our foods. Our food should be light and easily digestible and should have less of fat and less of spices. So if we consume less of fat and less of spices, then the reflux will be low. There is usually a valve between the food pipe and the stomach, that is the esophagogastric junction. Usually this valve is closed. When food goes down, it allows the food to go down. But if something comes from below upwards, it will not allow food to come upwards. So this is the lower esophageal sphincter. In some people, there's a big wide opening called the hiatus. In others, there could be a slight looseness of this valve. Otherwise, we call it a lax ileus. This will allow the stomach contents to come up into the food pipe. And this could be sometimes disturbing at nights too. So what should we do if one of you has reflux disease? So what should be done to take care of this symptoms? First of all, that one has to consume light food. So more of millets and grains. And if you're a non-vegetarian, you can take chicken or fish or egg white. And avoid red meat, or lessen the quantum of consumption of red meat. And egg yellow can be taken once in a way in small quantities. And we should avoid taking fried food like bonda bhaji, vada, samosa. All those deep fried foods can be avoided or taken in moderation. Coffee and tea can be lessened. Alcohol should be avoided. Smoking should be avoided. And if somebody has symptoms of reflux, then the citrus fruit consumption can also be slightly reduced. And one should not retire to bed immediately after consuming food. So there should be a gap at least of 2 hours of solids and 1 hour of liquids before one retires to bed. And the head end of the bed can be elevated with 6 inches wooden block so that the head is above and the foot is below. So the gastric contents or the stomach contents will not come into the esophagus or food pipe at night. So we should do regular exercises, keep our body mass index below 24, and for Asians below 23 is ideal. So regular exercise, minding one's own diet, can always help prevent reflux. And if the reflux is bothersome, then definitely you should get a gastroenterology consult. There are a few ways. We just put you on a medication called a proton pump inhibitor, so which suppresses acid, and also a prokinetic, which prevents the stomach contents coming into the food pipe. So it's a combination of proton pump inhibitors and prokinetics rather than proton pump inhibitors alone, which should be useful in the reflux disease. And this has to be taken lifelong. So if one does not want to take these drugs lifelong, we have other options. Endoscopically, we can tighten this valve. We have nice devices and gadgets which are coming. There's a procedure called ARMS, anti-reflux mucosectomy, which we've been routinely doing. We also have the stapler devices, just like the laparoscopic surgeons do. We can endoscopically staple the lower esophageal sphincter so that it prevents reflux of food. There is one more option. If there is a hiatus hernia, wide hiatus, still endoscopically the medicus can narrow the hiatus, or otherwise laparoscopically we can tighten this valve. So definitely there is a solution to gastroesophageal reflux disease, and one should not ignore the symptoms and immediately seek the consultation of a gastroenterologist.